This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about subtracting positive and negative numbers. So here's the first problem. I've got 3 minus 5. Now, what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to turn it into an addition problem. Addition is the opposite of subtraction. And let's also remember that positive numbers are opposites of negative numbers. Okay, so here's how this is going to work. I'm going to take this 3 minus 5, and I'm going to turn it into 3 plus, in other words, an addition problem. So I've taken the opposite of the subtraction problem, and to compensate for that, I'm going to take the opposite of the number I'm subtracting. I was subtracting a 5, so now I'm going to add a negative 5. So I've got 3 plus negative 5. Now I can use what I know about adding positive and negative numbers and solve this problem. So the signs are different. When the signs are different, what I do is I take the absolute value of each number and I take the difference of those values. So the difference of 3 and 5 is 2. In other words, I'm disregarding the fact that one of those numbers is negative. I'm taking the difference. The difference is 2, and now I'm looking at the bigger of those two numbers. So the bigger number was 5, and it was a negative number. So I'm going to use the sign that the bigger number had, which means I'll have negative 2. Now, if I want to visualize what I'm doing here, I might want to use the model that we used in one of the addition videos where we talked about positive and negative chips. So that would work something like this. Let's say that 3 is 3 positive chips in some kind of game that we're playing. And I've got to subtract 5. Okay, well, I've only got 3 chips, so I need a way of taking 5 away from that. Well, remember, a positive and a negative chip together neutralize each other. Positive, 1 positive plus 1 negative is 0. So I'm going to add a positive chip and a negative chip. That's like adding 0, and another positive chip, and another negative chip. And now I've got 5 positive chips and 2 negative chips. Since I wanted to take 5 away from the 3, and I've got 3, this is basically 3 plus 0. If I want to take 5 from 3, all I have to do is cross out my 5 positive chips, and I end up with 2 negative chips, which is the same thing I got when I did this problem arithmetically, and I got a negative 2. Okay, let's look at another problem. So here I've got negative 2 and negative 3. And I'm going to solve that by turning it into negative 2 minus 3. And I'm going to solve that by turning it into an addition problem. So I start out with negative 2. Instead of subtraction, I'm going to make an addition. So it's negative 2 plus. And then instead of positive 3, I'll make it a negative 3. So I've used the opposite of subtraction, which was addition, and the opposite of 3, which was negative 3. And now I've got negative 2 plus negative 3. When both of my signs are the same, my answer will have whatever sign they both had. So my answer is going to be negative. And I just have to add those two numbers, the 2 and the 3, and I get a negative 5. If we want to look at this in terms of chips, I can start out with 2 negative chips, and I want to take 3 away. Well, that would mean I'd have to have 3 positive chips, but I don't have 3 positive chips. So I'm going to add 3 pairs of positive and negative. Each pair is like adding a 0. So now I've got a total of 5 negative chips and 3 positive chips. My problem says to take 3 positive chips away, so I'll cross out those 3 positive chips, and I end up with 5 negative chips, or negative 5, which again is the same number that I got when I did this the other way. Okay, let's look at this one more time. Here I've got a 4 minus negative 3. So I'm going to turn this subtraction problem into an addition problem. Instead of it being 4 minus, I'll make it 4 plus. And instead of it being negative 3, I'll make it a positive 3. So this just becomes 4 plus 3, and that's 7. Now I'm going to do it visually. I'll get 4 positive chips, and I want to take away 3 negative chips. Well, I don't have any negative chips, so I'll have to add 3 pairs of positive and negative chips, which again is like adding 0 to the whole thing. So now I've got this 4 plus the 0 that I added, and I want to subtract 3 negative chips. So I'll just cross out those negative chips, and I'm left with 7 positive chips, which is what I got the first time around. Okay, so this is a way of doing subtraction in terms of by turning it into addition, or by visualizing it by using positive and negative chips. That's it for this one. Take care, and I'll see you next time.